I want to present the results EBU QC and FIMS integration we've done in the MXF Legalizer. So we joined two different standards together to present that in one product. Maybe you, what is your background you are interested in?
Yes, in workflow and integration of different products. So you've come across the FIMS standard with some of the products that we are using, so we're interested in finding out more about it. I just want to find out more about FIMS, so this looks to be a good way of starting.
So you're more interested in FIMS or in EBU QC? So the QC part of that?
I am more interested in FIMS, but please deliver what you need to deliver, that's fine.
Okay. So I like to talk about the EBU QC and FIMS integration we did with our MXF Legalizer. So what I want to present is the FIMS standardization work, a very quick overview. Then the EBU QC standardization work and how the two both come together and how CubeTech integrates the two standards. So if you look for what is FIMS developed, what is the background behind FIMS? So FIMS is a software SOA solution. So it's an integration framework, especially for media. It's more defined on the business side than on the technical side. It has specifies only the interfaces, how services are interconnected. And of course, it's already well recognized within the industry and has good support over the last years. So the good thing is FIMS understand the media demands, so the high bandwidth, long running processes, the formats, the metadata needs. So it's really defined for media. And I think that's a big advantage in the service-oriented architecture. So before you have a SOA system, you have tightly coupled functions in your product. Of course, the strategy for a few years now is to cut them off and put a media orchestration system in between, so that you have clear defined interfaces which communicate with the service and an orchestrator system that managed how the service are called. So that is the way how SOA potential is maximized within the media industry, and the same way FIMS works. So here the special thing I want to focus is how FIMS in the quality area, quality assurance is used. And that strategy is that we use the profile defined with a QA and the media, and we generate out of that a report in a standardized way with standardized interfaces. So we will become a report that signal whether we have whether a media has a fail or whether it passed the test items, and we can track the parameters and see that the tool is helpful and doing the job. So for that, the two groups are having to work together. So the FIMS do the work of a standardization of a service implementation and the interface definition, while the EBU QC group makes the main work in the standardization of the measurement parameters. And these two things work together. EBU QC is the second part here, and it's also a work in progress. So the quality control group has started 2 years ago with about 100 test items, which we defined. Now it's more than 200. So that means that you have very specialized tests, exactly defined with a related standard, and what you expect from the test, how the terminology is used. So you really standardize the type of tests to use. For that, the EBU designed the EBU I.O. QC. That is a portal at the web where you can grab together your QC tests, which you want to use in your own template, and then That is the idea behind move the template to a vendor system, and the vendor should only do the tests with the measurements you defined in that EBU QC system. For the IBC, the EBU specifies 11 test QC items, which we provide to the vendors to show how that should work. And that is shown on the next booth, how you can configure all that. So the basic idea of that demo is that you get an USB key with an XML, which is describing exactly the measurements they require. And you can use that and go to a vendor that support that test. If you look closer, what is on that template? It is, of course, it's an XML description. I can show how we implement that XML description. So we have an orchestration system that is able to natively manage FIM's media services, namely the capture service, the transform service, and the transfer service, and now, since this convention, also the QA service. So that is plugged into to an orchestration system. The orchestration system uses BPMN also as a standardization language, and we can communicate itself again via a FIMS interface. So that is interesting. So you see you have a layered approach where FIMS can take its role on seven different levels. So the aim of our product is to do QC and repair in one go. So check files for issues and repair and correct them lossless with the system. So for that we have analyzer suite where we do the analysis. This analysis drives the rule engine. That rule engine again decided about the repair strategy for each file individual. Then we have a post analysis. That means that we generate a new file and analyze the result file again with a standard analyzer. Then if it's good or bad, we can decide and sort the file, and we generate reports at the output. The interesting thing here is that we use not a proprietary, we use a reference analyzer to validate the output we generate, and that is all integrated directly in the workflow, so it's not an additional step, it's highly integrated in the system. So the quality assurance idea behind that is that we deliver files with exactly defined constraints. We do that for the German IID ZDF profile and for the AS11 DDP profile. And with a FIMS service interface, you have no longer any vendor lock-in. It's an open standard. If you are not happy with what we provide, you have very easy to change to someone else. At the end, we can generate a report describing exactly the defined values in the template and look whether your check was done and or whether we was able to repair the file to the requirements in that QA template. I think that's, from my side, important here to look at the EBU IO QC to see more how the portal is built. And I hope you get an idea how you can use it for product and how it gives added value to client. Thank you.